word, HPV-related cancers in women account for a large percentage of that cancer.
But now the CDC says around 70% of cancers of the back of the mouth and throat may be related to the HPV virus. KXAN's Leslie Rangel spoke with a doctor in Austin who says the new numbers highlight why it's even more important for young boys to get vaccinated as much as young girls.
The numbers in the U.S. are about 7,000 men each year will be diagnosed with an HPV-related cancer.
It's something surprising given many associate HPV with women.
Why would you want your children to have to go through that? Cervical cancer, penile cancer, head and neck cancers are devastating. They are disfiguring. They will affect your ability to have children and families.
Dr. Rachel Brightwell says some parents think the vaccine could be a free pass at sex.
It is at least, they think, 30 years of protection from the time you give it. So you're not automatically giving your teenager a license to go have intercourse. You're protecting them for their life.
She says some parents ask, what if their child only has one sexual partner in their life?
Okay, I have one sexual partner, but that person had two, and those two had two each. And so you're actually getting a much larger exposure than just your one sexual partner. And the fact of the matter is about 85% of the world's population will have been exposed to some form of HPV in their lifetime.
Doctors estimate vaccinating at a young age could eliminate up to 90% of HPV-related cancers. So if you're still on the fence, doctors say this.
The bigger question to me as a provider is why not?
In Austin, Leslie Rangel, KXAN News.
The CDC advises boys and girls get the three-dose HPV vaccine starting at age 11 or 12. The latest the CDC recommends is 21 years old for men and 26 years old for women.